right. So good evening to all of you. We have about 30 people in the classroom at this point of time, and there are more people joining in. So hi, Pearl. I think there's Jayesh's son. Hi, Jayesh, and your son. There's Atish. So there are a lot of people in the classroom. Any students, any kids, any older people in the classroom, please just type in your name and your, you know, what is that you do. Just quickly let me know. So hi, Arnav here. Oh, hi. Hi, Arnav. So there is Arnav here and there is Yashwith here. And so there's Cookie there. Hi, Cookie. Yeah, so there's Anushri and there's Arya Borhade. So there are a lot of students coming inside the classroom, and and it's always good to see people who are trying to learn something new. It's always good to see people who encourage their children. It's always good to see a lot of motivated children coming in the classroom. It just kind of feels great about it. Hi, Kyra, how are you? Shreshth is here. Yeah, hi, Shreshth. So, good evening to all of you. How is everybody feeling? Before I start, I'm going to start in about a minute's time. Before I start, I want to ask you a simple question. How many of you guys I had given a homework last week? Yeah, so I'd given a homework last week. How many of you guys, very honestly, tell me, how many of you guys did that homework? Very quickly tell me, how many of you guys were able to do that homework? How many of you guys did it? How many of you guys didn't do it? This is not like a school. So if you did the homework, please type, I did the homework. If you didn't do the homework, say, I didn't do the homework. If you say you don't know what the homework was, then you can say that, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't even know there was a homework. The only homework I know is the one which is given in the school. So, all right. So, Raksha, so I appreciate. So, Diksha says, I didn't do the homework. It's fine. But, Diksha, we have to learn this, that if we don't take efforts in learning, then we are not going to end up learning this. Now, please understand, I am going to give you a little bit of, I wasn't able to do it. So, next time, Sandeep Borhade, I think it's your son. So, yeah, so can I have a little bit of commitment from all you children, because what has happened now is that this group not only does have children, it also has parents who are slightly senior, who are about 65, 66, 67, 62 years of age, who have only heard about the stock market in a negative manner. And because of so, we have, we are trying to teach them also, and we are going to go very softly and very gently on that. So can we commit and say that I will do my homework, so that once I know that you have done your homework, I feel good about it. If I feel good about it, I will take a better session. If I take a better session, you will learn more. If you learn more, believe me, you will end up going to where you want to go in your life a lot more faster. So can I have, very quickly say, type, say, I will do my homework if you haven't already done, because the studies that we are going to do right now is very different from the studies which happen in school. They are going to be fun studies. They are going to be studies which you hopefully will do, which we will learn for the rest of your life. And hopefully you will be able to use what I teach you for the next 40, 50, 60, 70 years of your life. And what I'm going to teach you is going to be very, very practical. What I'm going to teach you is going to be very, very useful. What I'm going to teach you is going to be very, very interesting. So all of this. So it is not like learning trigonometry, or it is not like learning algebra, which you very rarely use in your life. What lessons we're going to learn are the lessons that will completely change your life, right? Now Anadita says that we are new students. So if you guys are new here, and if you are new students here, here's what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to show it to you. So this is the group of Facebook by the name of Big Bull. So this is the Big Bull group. You guys need to be a part of the Big Bull group. for that, or your parents need to be a part of it, or your grandparents need to be a part of it, or your neighbors, or somebody has to be who can give you an access to this. So while I know a lot of students are not allowed to be on Facebook, my children have a free flow access to Facebook because we use Facebook as a tool of learning. So there are different ways of using what we have in our life, right? Like we have a knife in our house. Now we can either use a knife to harm people, or we can use a knife to cut vegetables, to cook food for us. So what utility we have and what utility we use it for determines the use of it, right? So a lot of people come on Facebook and are basically doing time pass in life. And that's not what we do. So ever since my children were about 5 or 6 years of age, they have an access to Facebook, because we use Facebook as a tool of learning, as a platform for learning, as a platform for exchange of quality information, which can help us. Is this making any sense to all of you? If you are with your parents, and if your children with your parents, can you please tell your parents that we are going to use Facebook, for our own benefit, so that we are smart now, we are intelligent children, we are not like other children who only go in schools and mug up things which are in the chapter, and we write exams and we forget about it. They're not those kind of children. We are little smart children who learn more about how the world works, how life works, and we are going to be able to do that. So here's what we're going to do now, right? So if you go to this Facebook group, okay, you see this blue colored photograph. This blue colored photograph has got 4 links kept on it. So link 1, link 2, link 3, and link 4. Now these 3 links are the links of the videos of recordings of the earlier webinar. So we had earlier webinars, we had 3 webinars so far. This is the 4th one. So we've taken those links of those webinars and we have uploaded it on YouTube. So if you click on those YouTube videos on this link, let's say, let me just click on this link. And the moment I click on this link, you will go to the YouTube video, right? And you will be able to have a look at this entire YouTube video. And so this is the lesson number 3 of the webinar. So this is the webinar which we took last time, right? So you can have a look at this webinar, and there are lessons given there. So this is link 1, link 2, link 3, and in this blue photograph, after this webinar is over, I will take this, upload this, and I will put a link 4 over here. So link 1, link 2, link 3, link 4. And if you click on this, this is a playlist. So this, once you click on this, the entire playlist of link 1, 2, 3, and 4 will play in a sequence. So all the people who missed out on it, what you can do is you can go through the YouTube videos, take a paper and a pen, and this is the most important, okay? Take a paper and a pen, and you have to learn to do this, okay? And now, first lesson of your life today, or first lesson that I would like to teach you, or one of the most important lessons that I teach my children, is whatever you do in your life, whatever learnings that you have in your life, you have to write it down in a diary. So all my children have diaries. I have my diary. So you see, this is my diary. This is my 10th or 12th diary of such big ones. So I always write down, I get up in the morning and I write down my notes, whatever I, as important ideas, important thoughts, important things which I want to remember in my life, I write it down in this. My children have similar diaries and they have been writing it down for last 6 years, okay? So all my programs, all my courses that I run for rest of the students are also always attended by my children. And not only do they attend, they write down and take down notes for all my children. Let's say, for example, here is Arya. Arya is my son. Arya. So that's my son, Arya. And Arya, can you show them your notebook for what you have so that they know what is to be done? So this is one of the notebooks that he has. And he has about 5 or 6 notebooks. He's written so much. Okay. And this has got nothing to do with his school studies. This has got things which I teach him about the stock market, about life, about performance, about other things in life, right? So I need you guys to do this. You need to prove this to your parents that you are going to use Facebook for learning. You are going to use Facebook for very, very serious things in life, so that you guys have become a little bit, older now, a little bit matured now, a little bit serious now. You can be taken seriously in life, you have to prove this to your parents. And once you prove this to your parents, then your parents will take you that seriously. Does that sound good and exciting? Can you please tell me, does that sound good and exciting? Does that sound good where you suddenly feel that you are taken a little bit more seriously, you have a little bit more responsibility, where people are waiting for you, your parents can depend on you. You know, the buzzword here is the parents have to depend on you. So the word is that you need to be dependable in life. So I want you to write it down. Write all this word on your book and circle that word. And this is going to be one of the most important words that you are ever going to have in your life. And the number one reason why you will be successful in your life, in any aspect of life, whatever you want to do in your life, is the word dependable. You need to be dependable. And for you to be dependable, it has to start from your home. So you have to start from your home, and then other people have to be able to be depending on you. And if you are dependable in your life, you will suddenly start becoming very, very successful in your life. Guys, okay with this? Are you guys okay with this? Is this making sense to you guys? Right? Quickly telling me yes, no, I don't know. I've gone, I'm playing PUBG. I don't know, whatever, PUBG, whatever you guys are doing. Right? So this is what you're going to do, right? So we are going to take down notes. You're going to keep those notes. Those notes are going to be used for the rest of our life, and we are going to learn from that. So what I need you to, so here's how it is. You're going to click on this playlist whenever you have free time, not when you are taking time away from your school. You have free time, you know, you're going to take down those notes, sit down with a paper and a pen, watch that video on your phone, and take down notes. And those notes have to be collected in a book like this. And if I've given you some homework, you need to take your phone and do the homework and be up to date, so that next time when I take a class and when you tell me that I have done my homework, then I'm going to feel very good about it, and I'll be very motivated and inspired in life, and I want to teach you a lot more. Make sense? So here's what we're going to do now. So before I go further up, okay, so far, has anybody got any questions, doubts, or something that they did not understand of the last webinar? Anybody like that? If you have, you can ask me this question. Let me have a look at this question and I will take the next step of the webinar. I promise you today, from today onwards, first two or three sessions where I was trying to find the feet in the market, where I was trying to find the feet on the webinar. Okay. So once I was trying to do that, now I have understood what I needed to teach you and how I need to teach you. So we are going to make the sessions a lot more fun. So our sessions now are going to become a lot more fun, a lot more interactive, a lot more enjoyable. There are going to be a lot more of these things. All right? Okay. So Meera Shetty has a question about, sir, something about penny. So Meera, I had taken about 15 minutes to explain in my last webinar what are penny stocks and all that. What I would suggest is, and it doesn't look like you have attended that last webinar, which is fine. Can you please go back and look at the webinars and the recordings of the webinars, and you'll be able to understand that? Meera, can you just confirm this to me whether you'll be able to do that? And I promise you that you will be able to get your thing taken care of. So you will be able to learn it there. Right? Vedant Satish has said, sir, I understood what is demand, but I do not understand supply. So Vedant's question is, sir, I understand what is a demand and I don't understand what is a supply. Very simple thing, okay? Demand and supply. It's a very simple concept. There is demand and there is supply. Let's say, for example, yeah? So Vedant, do you play video games? Vedant, do you play video games? No, you don't play video games. So if you don't play video games, what is that you really enjoy and like in your life? Like my children, they don't like much. They don't like phones, but they do like to travel. So my children like to travel a lot. Yeah. So my son is always telling me, dad, let's go to Europe, let's go to Japan, let's go here, let's go there, let's go there. So he's demanding something from me, right? He's demanding something from me. So let's say, for example, you like games, or you like like games. So you go and tell your parents that I want so and so. You demand that. That is called as a demand. Now your parents don't want to give it to you. Why? Because playing games is a waste of time, right? So they will not give it to you. So there is less supply. There is no supply. So huge demand, no supply. Correct? Huge demand, no supply. Or for example, if you are playing cricket, okay, and you want to go and watch a cricket match, okay, there are only about 2,000 tickets for the cricket match. So only 2,000 people are able to sit down for the cricket match and watch the cricket match, which means, but there are 50,000 people who want to go and watch that cricket match. 2,000 tickets for that cricket match, but 50,000 people who want to watch that cricket match, right? It's an international cricket match. So the demand is for 50,000 people. But what is the supply? Supply is only 2,000 people. Demand for 50,000 people who want to attend it, but supply is of 2,000 people, correct? So the demand and supply. So you understand this? So far you understood? Demand and supply. So demand is what people want. Supply is what is given to this thing. So that is called as demand and supply. Now on the other hand, right? On the other hand, can you just go from here? On the other hand, let's say there is a cricket match, but it's not a very popular cricket match. It is a school cricket match. So there are 2,000 tickets, right? But only about 100 people want to attend it. So what is the supply of the cricket tickets? 2,000, right? But what is the demand for it? Only 100 or 150. So supply is huge of 2,000. Demand is only about 100 or 150. Huge supply, no demand. You understand? So when there are 50,000 people want to attend a class, want to attend a cricket match, and there are only 2,000 tickets, because there the demand is huge and the supply is very little, what will happen to the price of the tickets? The demand is of 50,000 people wanting to attend a cricket match, and the supply of tickets is only 2,000. So what huge demand, very less supply. What will happen to the price of the tickets? Okay, so Sandeep says price will drop, one says price will go up, one says price will lower, one says price will increase, one says price will go up. Okay, one says price will reduce. Okay, so here's what I want you to tell me. Okay, well, I want you to remember and write it down on your book. Okay, huge demand, less supply, price always goes up. Huge demand, less supply, price always goes up. Okay, if there are 50,000 people wanting a ticket and there are only 2,000 tickets available, the people who hold that 2,000 tickets will say, there are so many people who want to buy these tickets. So a 100 rupee ticket, I will sell for 1,000 rupees. Correct? The price will go up. So please remember and write it down. Huge demand, less supply, price always goes up. On the other hand, huge supply, very less demand, what will happen to the price? Huge supply, very less demand, what will happen to the price? Price will go down. Let's say there are 2,000 tickets for in the stadium, but only 150 people have gone to watch this thing. So the rest, about 1,800 seats in the stadium, are empty. Nobody wants to see them. So don't you think that the tickets will be given free of cost, because there are no one to see it? The price will go down. So here's what we're going to learn today. Okay. And very, very important learning in life. Huge demand, no supply, price goes up. Huge supply, no demand, price always goes down. This happens everywhere in life. This also happens in the stock market. If there is a huge demand for a stock and there is no supply, price will go up. And there is a huge supply and there is no demand in the stock, for that stock, price will go down. You guys can learn this. Okay, so all of you guys got this clearly about demand and supply? Very quickly tell me. You guys got this? Okay, I want you to remember this, because these are very, 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 very important concepts. Okay, Now, Arnav Arora says that, sir, could you please give me a quick introduction about penny stocks? Arnav, we will not do that. Please go and have a look at the first three videos, because last time I spent almost about 15 minutes explaining what penny stocks are. If you still do not understand, or if you still are not able to follow what penny stocks are, then you can ask me this question next time and I'll explain to you next time, right? Why? Because there are so many people in this classroom today, and a lot of people have already attended and learned it. And unfortunately, you didn't attend it. So there's no problem. I'll explain to you. But first, let us go ahead and do our homework first. And once you do our homework, you learn it. And then maybe you might not have the question. But if you do have the question, I will take it next time. Is that okay, Arnav? Okay, all right. So Pranav Nair is asking, is there something minimum number of stocks that need to be bought of each company? So Pranav's question is there any minimum number of stocks that need to be bought of each company? And the answer is no. There is no minimum number of stocks that you need to be bought. You can buy as many number of stocks as you want. There are people who buy one stock, okay, and there are people who buy 1 million stocks. So it depends really upon you. It depends how much money you have. So if you have a large amount of money, you can buy a lot of stocks. If you have small amount of money, you can also buy one stock, and it is perfectly okay. All right. Okay. And if you really want to learn the stock market a lot more better, here's what you guys got to do. Okay. You guys need to go and tell your parents, okay, that, Dad, why don't you buy me one stock? And you need to keep on watching that one stock to understand what happens with that stock, whether the stock goes up or down. Okay, so I'm going to teach you that. But if you are very serious about learning this, and you should be, then you should go and tell your parents that, please, it's okay if you don't give me a pocket money for 3 months. It is okay if you don't give me a gift for my birthday. But can you please buy me about one or two stocks or the company? You can take this company like Reliance Industries, which is a very, very good company. So you can buy one stock of Reliance, and then you can tell your parents, Dad or Mom, can you please buy me one stock of Reliance Industries, because I want to start investing or trading. And when you buy that one stock of Reliance Industries, guess what happens? You will be a part owner of Reliance Industries. Okay, let me say this again to you. If you buy one stock of Reliance Industries, and Reliance Industries in India is owned by the richest man of India. Okay, then you, accord along with him, will be a part owner of Reliance Industries, which means then at a certain level, the richest man of India and you will own the same company at the same time. Isn't that cool? Isn't that awesome? How many of you guys find this awesome? How many of you guys are ready to do this? Quickly raise your hands and say yes. How many of you guys are going to go and tell your parents saying that, it's okay if you don't give me a gift, it's okay if you don't take me out. I mean, one stock of Reliance Industries, because I want to be a partner. I want to own the stock of Reliance Industries, which is also owned by the richest man of India. And if he is owning a lot of stock of Reliance Industries, then I definitely also want to buy the stock of Reliance Industries, so that if he is doing something right, I will also do something right. Sounds good? Sounds exciting? So you should do that. Yeah. Okay. So now let me just take some more questions before I go ahead. Okay, so Arnav Arora says, sir, I did this and put my monthly saving and bought HDFC Life and Alchem. Excellent. So Arnav Arora here has already done that. Okay, and that should be a standard for you guys. That should be a good standard for you guys. You know, like my son, he has a portfolio. He has a very large portfolio, and he not only does he, so he's 17 years of age today, okay? He just finished his 10th standard, my elder son, he just finished his 10th standard, and he has a portfolio of at least 40 different stocks. And not only does he select those stocks himself, not only does he decide at what price he has to buy the stocks, he also comes and tells me if he sees a very good opportunity, because he's been trained into it for the last 7-8 years. He also comes and tells me that, Dad, I think this is a stock which you need to buy because this is at the right price. And I also buy the same stock that he tells me to do. Okay. So they don't come and tell me that I want to buy new shoes or new clothes or I want to do this. They tell me I want to buy this stock. Okay. So you need to be doing that. So Arnav has already done that. So excellent, Arnav. I'm very, very impressed with you. You have to do that. Now, Pearl Karanja says that, sir, when Reliance Industries was breaking out at 1600 and above, did you bought for me as I told her? Didi bought for me as I told her. Okay. So, Pearl Karanja is somebody who has been learning the stock market from me for a longer period of time. Her elder sister learns from me all the professional programs. Her elder sister's husband learns from me all the professional programs. So they are listed with me with some at least about 15 different programs. So not only both of them learn, Paul also learns the professional part of the stock market, and Paul knows a term called as a breakout. So later in the during the day, during the course, I will also teach you a term called as a breakout and a breakdown. So Paul is saying that when there was a breakout at 1600 levels, he bought the stock. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Very good. So there you go. So there are people in this group who are learning a lot. So Atish George is saying, would you recommend using Angel Broking to invest in stocks? And my answer is yes. So there are multiple stock brokers in India, and I'll just tell you a little bit of them. There is something which is called a Sher Khan, which is the largest broking house in India. There is something called a Raleigh Air. There is something called a Motilal Oswal, somebody called as Zerodha. There is something somebody called as 5paisa. So there are multiple brokers in India. All of these are reputed brokers. All of these are brokers who are aware, whom you can depend upon. You can Kite, you can take that Kite. Yeah. Kite is a software from Zerodha. So Kite is not a broker. So Kite is a software from Zerodha. But all of these brokers are excellent brokers. Now, what does a broker mean? Just to give you the easiest example. Let's say, for example, you want to buy an iPhone. Right? Now, you can't directly go to Apple and buy an iPhone. You can't do that. So where do you go? You will either go to Reliance Digital, or you will go to a company like Tata, which sells electronics, or you will I don't buy too many electronics, so I don't know. Or you will go to an Apple storeroom, or you will go to Vijay Sales. So these are 3 or 4 outlets where you can go and you can buy your Apple iPhone, right? So Reliance Digital, Vijay Sales, some of the Apple showrooms, specific Apple showrooms, these are the outlets where you can buy your Apple. So similarly, in the stock market, there are people who are dealers. So I'm just making it extremely simple for you guys to understand. They're called as brokers. So if you want to buy some stock, you need to go through brokers. Now, these are different types of brokers. So you can go and buy it from Sher Khan, Angel Broking, you can buy it from Raleigh, you can buy it from Zerodha, you can buy from all of these. Okay, so broker is somebody who's a middleman. Okay, so middleman or a huge organization. So we'll take one special session explaining to you what are brokers and what brokers do. Okay, so you can write down this question on this notebook, like I said to you. Write down this question on your notebook on the last page. So what you do is you can take out your last page, and anything that you do not understand, you have to write down the question, ask me that question later, and I'll be able to explain to you later. Is that okay with everyone? So will you guys do this? If you have any questions or doubts, write it down on the last page, and I'll give you an answer to those questions. Right now, we want to learn something. So I don't want to go into details about it, but I will give you an answer to that. Right. So I think the answer is yes. You can take Angel Broking and you can do that. So Megha Dalvi is asking a question. Sorry, not Megha. It's Megh Dalvi. Megh Dalvi is asking a question. Is it better to buy a stock when the price goes low? And the answer is yes and no. So there are different strategies and there are different techniques for it. There are, as professionals, we buy the stock when the price goes down, but we also buy the stock when the price goes up. Now, there are times where you can buy the stock when the price goes down, and there are times where you can go and when the stock goes up. So what Pearl Karanji was talking about is, she was talking about a breakout. So breakout is when the price goes up. So a lot of times we professionals buy when the price goes up, and that technical term for it is called as a breakout. So you can buy a stock when the price goes up also, not necessarily that it has to go down, and it's called as a breakout, right? So Megh, I hope I have been able to answer this question. Now Ananta is asking, sir, could you please answer the question, how to keep business stable, does that depend on demand and supply? Okay, so I want to answer this question. Anandita's question is, how to keep business stable, does that depend on demand and supply? So you have to understand, there is a business and there are stocks of the business. Okay, there is a business and there are stocks of the business. Let me give you an example and I explain to you. Let's say there is a business like Britannia Industries. How many of you guys eat Britannia? How many of you guys eat Britannia biscuits or Britannia ice cream or Britannia bread? How many of you guys do that? A lot of you guys, right? Or Britannia, right? Or how many of you guys buying HUL products, Hindustan Unilever, or let's say Nestle. Let's talk about Nestle because everybody, all the kids would know. Nestle comes up with Nescafe, and Nestle comes up with Maggi noodles, right? So I am pretty sure all of you guys enjoy eating Maggi noodles. I definitely enjoy eating Maggi noodles. They are very, very interesting and very tasty. And a lot of times we really, really enjoy eating Maggi noodles now. So the business of Nestle, the Nestle company, has a business of manufacturing and selling Maggi noodles, right? That is one part. Second part is, you can go and buy the stock of Nestle. That is another part. And these are two different parts. How much is the demand for Maggi noodles is determined by people like you and me. People like you and me go out in the grocery store, you buy Maggi noodles and you make Maggi noodles and you eat Maggi noodles. So that is the business part. Second part is whether we buy stocks of Nestle or not. So there would be a lot of people, okay, who are sitting there, including your parents, who would buy a lot of Maggi noodles, who would buy a lot of Nestle, who would buy a lot of Kit Kat, okay? And there would be a lot of demand for this Maggi noodles and Nestle and Kit Kat. But your parents might not buy the stock of Nestle, correct? On the other hand, there would be a lot of people who would buy a lot of stock of Nestle, okay? A lot of stock of Nestle, but they would not buy Maggi noodles because they don't like Maggi noodles, right? So there would be a huge group of people who would buy a lot of Kit Kat, okay? But they would not buy Nestle, stock of Nestle. There would be some people who would buy the stock of Nestle, but they would not buy Kit Kat. Why? Because they don't like Kit Kat. So there are two groups of people doing two different things. Then there would be also a group of people who would not only buy Kit Kat, but would also buy the stock of Nestle. Okay, so there are three groups of people. One, buying products and not buying stock. Second, buying stock and not buying products. And third group of people who buy stock and products together. And what I want you, so far understood three different groups of people. Are you guys able to understand three different groups of people in this talk as far as this business is concerned, right? Okay. So what you need to learn is, just because you buy Nestle stock does not mean you will buy KitKat. And just because you buy KitKat does not buy you buy Nestle stock. So all three things are independent of each other. There is no connection between all three of these things. Can you guys raise your hands and say yes to understand this? And these are three different things. So demand in the stock price, in the stock has got nothing to demand of chocolates. Demand of chocolates has got nothing to demand of stocks. And you could have to do both the things, right? Now, if you had to act like a very smart child, you need to go and tell your parents, saying, you know, dad and mom, you know, you buy so many Nestle packets. Buy so many Maggie packets, and we've been eating Maggie for the last 30 years, and we enjoy Maggie, and our neighbors enjoy Maggie, and my friends enjoy Maggie, and you drink coffee, and I've seen you drinking Nescafe, and your friends drink Nescafe. So then why is it that you are not buying the stock of Nescafe, which is Nestle? You need to ask this question. So are you guys going to go and do that? Are you guys going to go and ask your parents that if we are eating this, then, or for example, if we are buying Dabur honey at home, then we are buying Dabur honey and we enjoy it, then why are we not going and buying the stock of Dabur? Or if we buy Bata shoes every year, for the last 10 years we've been buying Bata shoes because our school needs it, and there is so much demand for Bata shoes, then dad, can you please explain to me why have you not bought the stock of Bata? How many of you guys are kids are going to go and ask these questions? Very, very important questions to your parents. And if you are doing this, then why are you not going to buy the stock? So you are okay to buy the product, but you are not okay to buy the stock. If you buy the product, the company makes profit. But if you buy the stock, then we will make profit. Now, let me say this again to you. Very interesting stuff. You buy the product, then the company makes profit. But if you buy the stock, we will make profit. And it is always better for us to make more profit. Am I right or wrong? So can you write this down? And I'm going to say this again to you. And I want you to write this down. And I want you to go and talk to your parents with this, saying, if we buy the product, like KitKat chocolates, then Nestle will make profit. But if I buy the stock of Nestle, then we will make profit. Okay, so I want you to do that. Okay, now let me just go a little bit backwards and let me just address what somebody else was saying so that, So Bhushan Chincholikar had written saying, hello sir, I have been giving pocket money to my father to purchase stocks, and he bought me 4 stocks for me. Sai, I am extremely impressed by you doing that. So Sai has written that, sir, I have given pocket money to my father to purchase stocks, and he bought 4 stocks for me. Excellent, Sai. I am very, very impressed with you. I think Sai, you also get to be a part of Super Trader program, because your father has been a part of Super Trader program for last 8 years. So if you are not a part of Super Trader program, will you go and tell your father that, dad, I also want to be a part of the bigger program, which is Super Trader, and learn a little bit more than that, because you are already inducted and know a little bit more about the stocks than the rest of the students here. Okay, so you do that, but I'm highly, highly impressed if you've done that. So Vedant Satish is asking a question. Hey, sir, does broker connect a buyer and a seller? And the answer is absolutely yes. The job of a broker is to connect the buyer and the seller. Okay, so what is the job of a broker? I'm making it very, very simple. The actual concept would be a lot more complicated. But I'm going to make it very, very simple. So I want you to remember that the job of a broker is to connect the buyer and seller. So buyer and seller gets connected by the broker. That's what is the job of the broker, right? All right. So let's move a little further up. and let us see if anybody has got any other questions or doubt that you want to say. This was Sandesh Mathri is asking a question saying, is it possible to buy many stocks of a company and its price goes up? People invest more in it and we sell our stocks and we make profit? And the answer is yes. So let me read this question again so that you guys understand this. His question is, and Sandesh Mathri is asking this question, sir, is it possible to buy many stocks of a company and its price goes up, people invest more in it, and we sell our stocks and we will make profits? And the answer is absolutely yes. So as more and more people buy a stock, as more and people invest into that stock, there will be a huge demand which is created. And when there is a huge demand which is created, what happens to the price? Tell me very quickly. Right, what happens to the price? The price surges. What happens to the price when a lot of people are buying that stock? Price goes up. And when the price goes up, for you to make profits, what do you have to do now once the price goes up? Once the price goes up, what do you have to do? You have to sell. So if you sell, don't you think you'll make profits? So a lot of people buy a stock, a lot of stock is depreciated. You create a demand, price goes up, you sell the stock at a higher price, you'll make profits. So absolutely right. Then Sandeep Borade says, sir, I have given my Diwali gift money to my father to buy stocks. So excellent. So Sandeep, I think it's your son who's writing this comments. So again, an amazing thing. Sandeep has been my student and his son is also. So Sandeep, here's what you need to tell your son, that you also need to get into the Super Trader program so that he can learn a little bit of professional side of investing and trading, right? But excellent. So far, we have gone ahead, and while we have answered this question, it has already been 8:45. And I have promised that we are not going to take a session beyond 45 minutes, and it has already been 45 minutes. So maybe what I'm going to do in this session is I will take this question, and let's see. So there's somebody else who has, Anandita has asked this question. Sir, if we buy the product, the company will make profit. But if we, the stock, it will be our profit, because then as the demand supply goes up and we will, and down, we will still stay in profit. Yes, Anandita, that's what it means, that if you buy the stock of the company, a lot of people are buying a product, lots of people are buying KitKats, and because lots of people are buying KitKats, the Nestle company is making a lot of profit. So if it's making a lot of profit, and people see that this company is making a lot of profit, so I want to own this company because this company is a very profitable company. So I will buy the stock, and along with me, a lot of people will buy the stock of Nestle. And because a lot of people will buy a stock of Nestle, there'll be a huge demand. And when there is a huge demand, price goes up. And when the price goes up, let's say you bought the stock of Nestle at 100 rupees and the price went up to 300 rupees. So all you have to do is buy the stock at 100 rupees, let the stock price go to 300 rupees, and you sell it at 300 rupees. So if you buy it at 100 and if you sell it at 300, how much is your profit? Meg Dalvi says zero. Meg, how is it zero? If you buy the stock at 100 and you sell the profit at 300, how much is your profit? Your profit is 200 rupees. Correct or not? No, Vedant, it is not 300, it is 200 rupees. So you are having a profit of 200. Now, 200 rupees profit on 100 rupees is how much percentage? 200 rupees profit on 100 rupees is how much percentage? 200 rupees on 100 rupees profit is how much percentage? Absolutely. There is, who's
Meg says 50. Meg, I need to speak to your maths teacher. If you're saying it is 50%, no, it is not 50%, it is 200% profit, right? So this is what you have to do. Yeah, so you have to buy the stock, hold that stock for it to go up. So all you have to do is buy extremely good quality profitable stocks, and the price will go up and you'll make money, right? Anybody else has got any questions? Sir, is it possible that our fourth Thursday session we can keep? Kanchan is saying, is it possible that out of four Thursday sessions, you can keep the last Thursday session to clear doubts or asking questions and the first three sessions for actual learning? Yeah, we can do that, Kanchan. But what happens is, if there are people, we are addressing small children from the age of 7 to age of 20, and if they do not get, so stock market inherently is slightly a complex subject. And I'm trying to make this subject as entertaining and as simple as possible so that people are able to understand it. And the worst of it is that I'm not there, that these kids are not in front of me. If they were in front of me, then I would probably be able to explain a lot more better, but they're not. So I can't see people. If I can't see people, I have to go a little bit slow. So I would much rather, while I would love, in fact, all my presentations are already, all my subject matter is already, the syllabus is already, but if I don't answer questions and if people have doubts in their head, then what I teach further, right, will not be able to be understood, right? So, if you're not able to understand the basic, then you will definitely not be able to understand the advanced. So hence it is increasingly important for me to answer all the questions before I go forward. So while I have the syllabus ready and your suggestion is very, very nice, but unfortunately I don't see a way around that, right? So Kanchan, good suggestion, but let's first clear the doubts. Is that okay? All right, so I think we have taken a lot of questions, and a lot of these questions would also help a lot of students. And so what we can do is, now that I've given answers to all the questions, what we are doing is, we are already about 15 minutes into the session. We can have the next session the next time, okay? Maybe next week or week after that. I will let you know on the Facebook group, okay? And we will take up the session. So I was not able to teach today what I wanted to teach, but unfortunately that is how it is. But we need to go slow. I need to be sure that everybody is learning. I need to be sure that everybody does not have any doubts and questions. I need to be sure that everybody is on the same page before I go forward. How is that, everybody? So was this session good enough and slow enough for you guys? Did you guys learn anything today? So Anandita is asking, how does the price go up? That we will take it next time, right? So here's what I want you to do. Okay, this session will be recorded. The session will be updated. It will be updated tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Please go through all the sessions, session 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. And if you have any questions and doubts on that blue one, which I had put up over here, so you see this blue one, please type in your questions below this. Okay, if you don't type in your questions below this, then I will not know that you have doubts. And if I don't know you have doubts, then I will not be able to clear those doubts for you. And then we'll only go into the loop of you asking questions and me explaining it to you, and you asking questions and me explaining it to you. Will waste your time. So next time onwards, go through all the four of them. If you have any questions or doubts, write it down. I will take those questions and then I will go one step at a time, right? So so I think this is where we're going to start this thing. So this is how we're going to do. So Vedant is saying, sir, will you teach the formula for simple and compound interest? Vedant, I will depend on your teachers from maths to teach you the interest of simple interest and compound interest, okay? I'm not going to do that for you. Your maths teachers will do that. Sandeep Borade is asking, sir, instead of typing the learnings, can I post the photo of the notes of Arya Arya, the reason why I ask you to type the notes is because you have already taken down the notes, so it has already inside your head once. If you sit down and type the notes again, what will happen is you will do a revision one more time, and if you do a revision one more time, it will only remain inside your head, right? So I would suggest that you type your notes again. When you become a little older, anyway, you'll have to learn how to type, and you'll have to do that in your office or wherever you're working. So just sit down and type it again. Take some time, type it. You will learn it a lot more better. So it is for your benefit. Okay. So Meg says simple and compound interest was taught in school. You're right. Anadita says, sir, can we type the questions in the YouTube comments? You can type the questions in the YouTube comments. And the best is you type your questions on this blue photograph on the comment section of this blue photograph. So if you type it over here, I will be able to get it, right? So thank you, guys. Thank you for your time today. Thank you. I'm going very slow because I've been told that I should go slow. But please go through the entire video again, or if you've typed down your notes, here's what you've got to do. I'm going to put up a post now, and whatever that you learn today, and I'm observing what everybody's learning, and I'm observing who's typing, I'm observing who's not typing, I'm observing who's taking an effort, I'm observing who's doing what, and if you impress me enough, I will give you something which you will be very, very happy about in your life, right? So if you impress me, then there are some gifts coming your way. So you need to work hard. You need to show me that you're working hard and you are interested, and you need to do all that. So once I put up the note, like last time I put up a note here, if you see this, there's a note here saying that what was your learning? And this one did a fabulous job. Raj Handa's son did a fabulous job saying with the concepts that we learned today. You type it over here. Similarly, whenever you put up a post, so you write down all your learnings on that post so that we know what you have learned, what you have not learned. Right? Is that okay? Is that okay with everyone? Will you be able to do that? All right. So whatever is your learnings today, whatever that queries and your doubts were cleared, take about 20 minutes of your time. Sit down and type it down here and regularize it. So I'm going to put up a post in about 5 or 10 minutes time, and you'll be able to go ahead. All right. So till the time we meet next time, I hope you had a good time. Make sure you go and tell your parents that you need to buy the stocks. Now, here's the homework. Homework is you are going to go inside your house, and most importantly, homework. And I want you guys to sit down and do this homework. The homework is you're going to go inside your house. You're going to look at all the things that you consume, all the things that you buy. Okay. Find out which company is producing that, and find out whether that company is listed in the stock exchange. And if it is listed in the stock exchange, you need to go and tell your dad that, why don't you buy the stock? Like, for example, this is my diary, right? Now, if I take this diary and I turn this diary around, okay, you guys can see this. If I turn this diary around, you can see there is word ITC written there. So if I'm buying the diary, okay, you can very well buy the stock of ITC also. Because a lot of people are buying the diary, a lot of people would also buy the stock of ITC. So this is what you need to do. Will you be able to do that? So you go in your kitchen, okay? You don't have to do it for the foreign brand. You can do it for the Indian brand. You go in your kitchen, you go inside this thing, and you find out which are, let's say, for example, if you take Dabur Honey. Now, what is the company? It's Dabur. Or if you go inside and you find out Nestle. So what is the company? Nestle. What does it make? Maggie. So, or if you go and take the chai patti, Brooke Bond ka tea. Now, Brooke Bond tea is made by which company? It is HUL. So, you need to write this down and write as many products that you see in your house and the subsequent company. So, you write down the name of products in your diary and the subsequent companies in your diary, and you find out which are the companies. And then you tell your dad and mom that, you know, we have so many products. We will also buy one stock of each of these companies so that I start my journey of becoming the next Warren Buffett of the world. Did you know that Warren Buffett started doing this when he was 9 years of age? Warren Buffett started buying stocks of companies when he was 9 years of age. My son started learning the stock market when he was 6 years of age. In fact, when my son used to be 6 or 7, when I used to have physical classes, my son used to teach in that classes. A lot of people are aware of it. A lot of people also don't know. So my son, who's Aryo, whom you met right now, used to teach in my classes about the basics of it. So a lot of you guys are a lot. My elder son, who's 17 today, okay, he's going to turn 17. He's not even 17, he's 16 right now. He's going to turn 17 in a month's time. He has his own trading platform, his own broker, his own money. He takes his own buy and sell calls. He knows which stocks to buy, which stocks not to buy, what price to buy, what price not to buy, when to buy, when to sell. He knows it all. Because that is going to be his career, right? So there is no reason why you can't do that. So homework, very quickly. One, type down whatever you learned today. Two, go in your kitchen, go in your home, find out what products it is, find out which companies. Go and tell your parents, these are the stocks I need you to buy. One stock. Okay? So I see you next week. Goodbye and good night.